Joining us now is Atike Chude, Secretary, Joint Action Front. Thank you very much for joining us on the news this morning. What is your group up to this time? Because we recall how you mobilized Nigerians in 2012 over removal of fuel subsidy.
Yeah, the primary motivation of the Joint Action Front is to have a country that works, to ensure that the Nigerian people enjoy the fruits of the country's resources, to ensure that jobs are provided for Nigerians, to ensure that Nigerians have a better life, access to education, access to healthcare, infrastructure, and all that, a better life for the Nigerian people. That is what is our interest. And when we responded to the increase in the pump price in 2012, we are motivated by this interest, that there is nothing, we cannot do so much for our country, that when situations like this arise, then we also have to motivate the people, we also have to mobilize the people to fight for the interest, because sometimes the interest of governance diverges from the interest of the Nigerian people itself, the people that they govern. And that we think that this is such a time where the vast majority of our people are living below the poverty line, where the situation in this country, the socioeconomic situation in this country, has degenerated to such an extent that Nigerians are barely surviving. And then you now impose this kind of a hardship on the people once more. I think it is wicked, it is punitive, and Nigerians deserve much, much better than what is going on today.
To be clear, are you calling a protest or dialogue?
The government has taken a decision, and you know, the funny thing, I was just listening to your interview with Timmy Presilva, and then the Lai Mohammed, the Minister of Information. And if there's anybody that should not be talking at this particular point in time, it is Lai Mohammed, because in 2012 he made certain statements about the problem with in the fuel sector, and they said, and he said at that particular point in time, that the pump price of fuel was increased, that the price of fuel, based on their own forensic analysis, should go down to about 34 naira, and that the government should fix the refineries and all that. And so these are some of the things that they had promised. They made promises about revamping the entire petroleum sector, ensuring that turnaround maintenance is effectively done in all the refineries, and then stop the exportation of crude oil and refining same and bringing it back to Nigeria, which depletes our foreign exchange resources. And all of this they have failed to do, and again, Nigerians have to pay the price for inefficient governance and the incompetence in governance. And so we are definitely going to mobilize Nigerians, because this is one insult too many. And that is the essence of our intervention. Nigerians have suffered for so long. We cannot keep leaving Nigerians, to suffer under the vagaries of this kind of politics and the actions of
The question would be,
It's unfortunate, yeah.
Do you have the buy-in of labor unions? Because we hear they are also thinking of dialogue for now. They're not looking to take on the streets. It may also be counterproductive for you if the unions do not work in tandem with you.
Let me tell you that the 2012 protest, which is the biggest so far in the history of this country, was started by essentially the civil society, not labor. It was the Joint Action Front, which has always been in partnership with Nigerian labor, that called out Nigerians to the streets, and they responded in their numbers because the time was ripe. Labor only got into the mix about 7 days after that particular protest has started, and the rest is history. So this is not just about labor, it's about Nigerians, it's about the civil society themselves also. And so it will be good to get the buy-in of labor. We hope that they will be ready to fulfill their historical duty and historical mandate, because after all, it is also their people that are suffering. And labor, I want to believe, should have a bigger motivation now to even get involved in mobilizing Nigerians. Because right now, we know the action of inflationary trends on the salaries of workers, including workers under the Nigerian Labour Congress. And of course, you know that the minimum minimum wage of 30,000 naira, about 22 states out of the federation have refused to pay. So are you going to say, are we saying that the workers, even though we know that the 30,000 naira minimum wage was grossly inadequate and a scandal, but yet we have a situation where most state governments are not paying, and then to now impose this extra hardship. So what it means ultimately at the end of the day is that some categories of Nigerians are not wanted within the Nigerian Federation. They should just disappear from the face of the earth, and that cannot be tolerated. So Labour has a historical duty to respond to what is going on, because their members are going to be victims of the inflationary trends that are going to follow as a result of this unwarranted increase in both the pump price of petroleum products and in the almost 90 to 100% increase in the price of electricity.
Okay, to be clear, there are a number of issues. We have the tariff, we have the taxes, we have the fuel price increase. What is the goal of your proposed protest? Is it to bring back subsidy, which according to some experts is going into the pockets of few? Or what is your own interpretation of subsidy regime?
The primary person pushing this subsidy story is the man who said that subsidy was a fraud, that there was nothing like subsidy. And I'm talking about the president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, President Muhammad Buhari. There are so many, there are video clips out there on social media everywhere where he was so angry and said that the whole thing is a scam, the whole thing is a fraud. A lot of the principal people in this government today and within the All Progressive Congress, the APC, said there was nothing like subsidy. Of course, you know that was part of the fallout of the 2012 protest. So, as they say, what goes around comes around. Now the same subsidy issue is haunting all of them, where they are all beginning to wake up and tell us that subsidy actually exists after they had lived in denial for a very long time. Now, but the issue is, why do we have subsidy in the first place? And to answer that question, you ask yourself another question. Why are the refineries not working? As they say that the refineries will work because of what they were intended to do with turnaround maintenance in those refineries. Why have they not built new refineries? It has been 5 years now since they came into power. If refineries have been built, then there will be no need for subsidy from that perspective if we look at it. So when Lai Mohammed talks about price of petroleum products being the cheapest in Africa, in West Africa, Nigeria being the cheapest in West Africa, he's not saying anything new. This is something that governments over the years have also come up with. These documents about the cheapness of fuel. So there is nothing new about it. But the question you have to ask is, how many of these countries that he mentions are actually producing fuel in West Africa? And besides, are we not entitled to enjoy the benefits of being Nigerians, of the resources of our country? Is it a bad thing? All over the world, subsidies are being placed on certain categories of certain sectors of their political economy. In agriculture, for instance, in the United States, in Switzerland, and parts of Europe, in the steel industry, subsidies are being put in place to protect local industries and to protect the workforce in those places. So there is nothing wrong about subsidy. And besides, these subsidies they are talking about is going on in the midst of so much gargantuan corruption that is going on in virtually every ministry, every department, every agency of government, just like we have seen with the NDDC, even within the EFCC, and then the pension fund in this country. So we need to begin to tackle some of the critical issues. The cost of governance is also another issue. Before you even begin to talk about this issue of subsidy, which is contentious, let them give us a cost component of the things that go into the exportation and importation of fuel in this country, so that we ourselves can actually determine what constitutes subsidy in Nigeria. For instance,
thank you very much. I'm afraid that's the much time we let us. Thank you so much for your thoughts on the proposed strike and fuel hike.
Thank you.